off with my bare and naked face, of course. The first step is our eyebrows. We gotta frame out our face, so I'm taking my very ratchet Lorac Mega Pro 2 palette and filling in my eyebrows. I wanted to go for a straight brow look because that is how my eyebrows are, but obviously that's not attainable for everyone. As for my foundation, I mix three foundations to get a shade that matches me. One that's yellow toned, one that's neutral toned, and one to darken it up, and I blend it out with this Japanese face sponge. Then I conceal my dark circles and anything else on my face that I think needs to be hidden, and I blend it out with the same sponge. Next is time for our blusher. We are going for a very, very, very blushed look because it's kind of my favorite thing in the entire world. I know it's not everyone's taste, but I absolutely love just super intense under eye blush. It just is so adorable to me. And then we are setting our eyelids because we did conceal them and just darkening them up a little bit, making a little bit more of a sickly look using this blush from Daiso. Then I am taking my Anastasia Beverly Hills Moonchild Glow Kit and I am highlighting my inner corner just to lighten up the eyes and the face just a bit. Then I am taking this Dolly Wink eyeliner and lining my eyes. Not much of a winged liner, just extending my natural lash line out to make the eyes appear bigger. We want to define the eyes, and while that is drying, we are going to move on to the faux freckles. I'm taking this dark Makeup Forever foundation, and I'm using the end of this mermaid makeup brush, tapping the freckles on, and then tapping them out with my finger. It is very important that you tap them out with your finger, because if you don't, when you're using this technique, they will look way too harsh and not very real. This also helps the freckles be less circle-shaped and be more naturally shaped like freckles actually are. Now, I went a little heavy on the nose because that's the way I like it, but you can do it however you want. For the lips, I decided to do a gradient lip. I started by adding some red eyeshadow in the center of my lips, and then I went in with this Lime Crime lipstick and put it in the very center to deepen the gradient. Now that our eyeliner is dry, we can go back to our eyes. I'm just curling my lashes and applying mascara to my top and bottom lashes. Then to finish up the whole look, I'm taking the Anastasia Moonchild Glow Palette again, and I am highlighting the tip of my nose, as well as under my brow bone, above my eyebrows, as well as on my cheeks and on my Cupid's bow. Then blending that all out to make it look a little bit more natural. And that is it for this makeup tutorial. If you recreate this look, please be sure to tag me on Instagram or Twitter so I can see. Also, please be sure to turn on my notifications to know when I post, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys!